When he rotates this way, the guard will spin one way, and when he rotates the other way, it counter spins. This right here is a turbidity shroud. It's on the back side, it's got a comb that combs through these teeth, knocking the debris out. The idea behind that is to reduce the resuspension of material as this head's turning around back into the water column. In this situation here, it's not so critical because there isn't an environmental component as far as turbidity, but in other jobs, that's a crucial factor. This here, we can rotate. This is basically a high torque motor, which we can rotate in either direction. We have variable speed control. We typically keep the speed slow for the so we get a lot of, say we have a diver and we need to get in under a pier or something. We actually have a hose that hooks up to this, a 50-foot hose, with all the controls are right on the end of the stinger, and the diver can actually take that in and use it to clean out any remote areas where we can't get a full-size machine in. And actually, he actually takes over control of the whole pump and is able to safely operate. We're able to keep it moving through the bypass system. I think I mentioned this machine generally advances 2 feet at a time after it makes its swing back and forth. That noise you hear is the comb is going through the back of the through each one of the rings to scour out the material. Now when we deploy this, we're going to be deploying it in this application with that crane. Typically we've got to get up over the guardrail. What we'd like to do in the future is we'll make this much more self-sufficient as far as not needing a crane on site. This thing will be able to mobilize itself in and out.
Yeah.